Hello, welcome to my channel. Welcome to the first video, my very, very first one. So it might be a bit ropey here and there, but we'll have a good go. The first one I'm going to be doing is something really, really special. I've had this hanging around up in the loft for a long time. It's something my dad bought for a university course many moons ago, and is, I believe, a 1980 microcomputer board from Texas Instruments. This is the RX Components branded one. So I know it has a fault, small one, so we're going to be looking at that. So first video I'm going to do will be looking at that fault and fixing it. The second one I'm going to do is going to be some upgrades. So I want to bring this up to the university basic level. So expand the RAM, change the ROMs. Quite some interesting challenges there, mainly sourcing components for one. So we'll get on to that one. So yeah, let's get going on this. So here it is, the TM990U89, serial number 9727. So quite a rare beast, I believe. I've had a good hunt around on YouTube and various places for any info on this, and very, very little to say the least. I've had this for quite some time. It was originally belonged to my dad, and it has the board. It's got the original acrylic case, which I've currently removed and put somewhere safe so it didn't get marked, and I have the original manual for this as well. Chunky. And this has all the information you need in it to upgrade it and various other bits and bobs. So first thing I'm going to do is just power this thing up. I've already had it powered up before. I'll power it up again and I'll show you what the small fault is. It does boot and there's no reason why it wouldn't work. It's more of a cosmetic fault than anything. So let's get down to that one. So here we are in subdued lighting mode. So I'll show you it working. I've jerry-rigged up a supply here. So I've just taken apart a PC Molex, uses the same size pins. Just put that in there. That's rigged up to a PC power supply. So this board's a little bit odd. It needs plus minus 12 volts and 5 volts. It won't boot without any of them present. So you have to have all of them there. Hopefully you can see that CPU ready. Take the light away. Might be a bit clearer. And the little fault we're going to look at is these lights down here. So when I power up, number 3 doesn't blink. So we're going to trace that back and find out where that fault lies and why that is not lighting. And hopefully it's not the CPU. Otherwise that's game over. Parts for this thing, as you can imagine, are rarer than unicorn poo, so we're not going to find replacements for the main components. So here we are on the schematic. And here we've got the I.O. controller chip here, the 9901. And down here we've got the LEDs, there's CR3 and R3. So I've already checked R3 is 120 ohms. The diode LED is checking OK. And pins 1 and 2 of the 7416 is where the problems are. We've got pads E31 and E32 if we want to check. They go up to P1 on the I.O. controller, pin 37. And then also feeding down to U9, which is 10K pull-up resistor network on there, going up to 5 volts. So we'll check out all of those, make sure there's nothing strange going on there. Right, so let's have a look at this. Pin 1 and 2 on here. So 1 is the input. There is a pulse. Right, cool. Missed that on the other one. Let's have a look at pin 2, which is the output. I can already see that's just wobbling all over the place. It's just noise. Okay, I think I found the culprit then. 7416. So let's have a look at swapping that out. So this one, let's get some flux on there to help things along a bit. This is going to be old solder. so it's not going to be lead free. We're talking late 70s, early 80s here, so that's not going to be an issue. Right, so let's get the extractor in place. I'll use a solder sucker. I'm not the best at this, and they have bent some pins over, which doesn't help. So here we go. One. Two. Lifty lifty, that'll do. There we go. And just want to be very careful not to lift the pads. Just that pin holding on, isn't it? There we go. Got him. That hole really wants to hang on to its solder. Let's just put a bit of a squeeze on there. Apologies if I've gone off camera. There we go. Right. Just clear that hole. There we go, clear. So clean this up, I'm gonna socket this. I'm not gonna put it back as it was. Not too keen on that there. That's soldered. They've tinned that trace. That's a bit iffy. Anyway, oh yeah, I'm gonna socket this. I'm not putting it back with a chip in there. So if that ever fails again, it's a lot easier to change it. So yep, there's our suspect. So just to verify that, I'm gonna whack it in the tester. Right, so here we're in XG Pro. I'm just gonna do the Logic IC test. I'm gonna put a 7416 into there. And we'll just do a test. It's coming back as testing normal. Now, I'm a bit suspicious of that. Maybe the heat did something. So it could have been an internal connection gone wonky, but I'm not going to trust this. Off screen, I've just done a diode test on the LEDs as well, and it is just faintly lighting up and the same as all the others. So I'm suspicious of this chip. So I will put a socket in and I'll put the new chip in and we'll see if that cures it. Now, we know we've got a signal coming from the I/O controller. We've seen that on the scope, so it doesn't get from one side of the chip to the other, although it is testing normal in XG Pro, but yeah, very suspicious. Right, so I've got some IC sockets. I've had these for donkey's years, still nice and shiny. This back in the days when they used to give you a rubber bung and not just sticky tape. So we will use socket for our chip. Something like that. So yeah, other way around. Yep, we'll get that in and we'll solder him up and then we'll test out our new chip. Yep, I'm a squirty bottle and toothbrush man. I think this works really well. It's in there, removes any loose gubbings. Let's get in there and give it a dab. Okay, all clean and ready to cook. All right, and so our socket is going to go in here. Are we in? We are. Okay. And I'm just going to do a flick and a flick just to hold that in place. So yeah, just flick those two pins over. Stops it dropping out. And right, ready to rumble. Bit of flux. Helps things to flow nicely. Let's hit the fan. And got a flux core solder. Got a blob on the end. It's just that off. Start nice and fresh. We're up to temp 427. I'll turn that down a bit. 400. Off we go. Okay, so we have 7416. This came from a reputable supplier. And I've already put this through the tester. So just pop him in the socket. Sometimes you have to give them a little squish. In we go, and seated. Right, let's give it a try, see what he does. So, moment of truth, we've resocketed our chip, so just gonna fire him up. Four LEDs, nice. So we did have a faulty 7416. Job done. Right, next video is modifications. I want to try and get University Basic on this. Then we can use a serial port up in this top corner over here. So we've got a serial port here. So we can connect the terminal to it. And it will be a little bit more computery, let's say. So that involves filling up the option ROM sockets and populating a few components, fitting a socket, and then seeing what happens. The big mystery is I've got a 9902 which goes in, see that one, can't remember which, U31 or the other one, and that is a communications chip. And you can't get them anywhere. I've managed to source one, but it did come off AliExpress. I don't know if it's genuine. I don't have any way of testing it apart from putting it in here. So I guess we'll find out. If not, then, well, I might have a little project. I might try and emulate it, but we'll see. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Obviously, if you like this one, like and subscribe. This is a complicated little beast. It's not something you see every day. One of these training devices. Yeah, I used to teach people machine code. Oh yeah, if you like it, like and subscribe. That'd be brilliant. Help the channel out. And I'll see you next time.